G'day and welcome back to Buildsum, and what I want to do in this video is show you how to set out the position of the members for a hip end such as this. So this is obviously the end result, so let's get back to the start. So here are our plates, and this end is going to be a hip end. So the first thing we have to do is we have to find out the half span of our building, and we measure that in. So we'll go down here and measure the half span from the outside of our plate. And it just happens to land on the inside of this wall here. So I'm going to mark that position with a center line. I'll normally just do a dash line because it's not going to be a permanent mark, not one we have to work to. So I just dash that in and you put CL on there, center line, so you know it's the center of your rafter. So this will be the center of our crown end rafter. So I'm going to then mark out the position of my rafter, half the rafter thickness either side of that line. So my crown end rafter will sit right there. Once I've got my crown end rafter in place, I can then mark out the remainder of all my creepers, and they're just going to go in at the standard creeper spacing from there. So I'm going to start on this side. I'm going to do into over measurements or center measurements for my rafters from that point. So 600 to that one, so from this edge to this edge, so they're centered. And we'll work our way back away from the corner, doing that until we get right down into the corner. This one's pretty close to the corner. Some people would say you don't need it, but you need something out here to pick up your fascia. So I've marked out the position of all my creepers down this side of the roof. So now I can go over to the other side and do the same thing. So again, I'm going to do into over measurements. I'm going to start on this side and go to that side of that mark and do that the whole way down till I get to the corner. So that's my end done. So now I can come around to one side, and again I'm going to measure my half span from outside the plate up to what will be the center of my first centering rafter. So again, center line, the rafter is positioned over the center line, so halfway and halfway, and then we again move or mark out our common spacing or our standard spacing away from that position. So 600 centers again, all the way down to our corner. I'm going to jump around the other side of the roof again, measure our half span, put our center line mark in. Position our first rafter halfway over that mark and measure back our 600 away from that. So 600's all the way down till we get down to the corner. So now I've got the entire hip end marked out for my rafters. So just so you get an idea, my two first common rafters, my centering rafters, are going to go there. They're the ones that pick up the end of the ridge. My crown end is going to sit on that mark. Of course, my hips are going to sit across the corner, and then my creepers will go into position. Now, the other thing we have to allow for, of course, is our ceiling frame. So you can see here, the ceiling frame, or the ceiling joists here, they all sit on this side of these creepers and rafters. And across the end, all the trimmers are sitting on the other side, that side there, of the rafters. So when we mark out our roof, because generally you're going to build your ceiling frame first, you mark out the position of your rafters, and then you pick a side and mark that as the position of your joist. So on the right-hand side of my rafter, I'm going to go around and put in a mark for my joists. So that way we can build the ceiling frame, not interfere with any of our rafters, and then we can have that ceiling frame to work off while we're doing our roof, and then we can put in all the roof members. So there you go, that's just a quick video on how to set out a hip roof end.